It has been a windy and rainy day 9 in Guangzhou. But as it comes to an end, you take a look there at the Universiad Cauldron. In today's highlights, the men's volleyball bronze medal match between Argentina and Chinese Taipei. We'll go to a soggy pitch to watch Japan take on Canada in the women's bronze medal match. From athletics, we'll look at high jump, as well as the 4x100 women's relay. The individual all-around competition takes place in rhythmic gymnastics. We'll look at badminton for some outstanding action there. And finally, 3 gold medal matches in tennis. Two countries that have never medaled in men's volleyball would meet at the Uamju Gymnasium in bronze medal final action. Chinese Taipei, they lost 3-2 in a close semifinal match to Ukraine, and Argentina lost 3-0 to Russia in their semifinal. We join it in the second set. Chinese Taipei won the opening set. But there's Manuel Lescaut-Auer of Argentina off the Chinese Taipei block and out. There's a nice dig by Juan Reganti, and then a soft hit there by Lescaut-Auer finds the floor. Now set point. There's a quick set by Reganti and then hit by Imhoff. Argentina wins this second set 25-21. Now to the third, 18-17, Argentina leading. Chinese Taipei with a quick set of their own. That's Huang to Chun Ching Huang, and he gets the kill. Now from the back row, Lescaut-Auer with another huge attack. And Argentina now up 19-18. Argentina again. There is Mariano Vildosla, and that hit can't be dug up by Chinese Taipei. Argentina now up 2. We'll move now to set point, and a huge serve there by Lescaut-Auer, and he will seal the set 25-22 in favor of the Argentinians. Late into the fourth set, Argentina up 22-19. And guess who? It's Lescaut-Auer again with the kill. Argentina 2 points away from bronze. Next there, a quick set for Facundo Imhoff. And his attack hits the floor. Argentina right close to bronze. Here we are on match point. And Juan Villaruel, that hit to the back corner will land in for the set and the match. Argentina wins its first ever medal in men's volleyball, 3-1. Football action, the women's bronze medal match from the Nadju Public Stadium. Very wet field for these athletes today. Canada has never medaled at Universiad in women's football, while Japan has 3 silver and 1 bronze to their credit. Here's Satoru Mochizuki, the head coach of Japan. Here in the 22nd minute, a beautiful header by Ai Yokoyama off the pass from Miyuki Takahashi. You see it there, perfect play. Japan up 1-0. Now to the 30th minute. Now Kawahara. She's sent in alone and she will rifle one home past Vandal. And Japan now up 2-0. There you see, great shot to the top corner. Moments later, that pass spills off the foot of Courtney Schellenberg, and Marin Hamamoto will chip one up and over Marie-Joëlle Vandal, and Japan now pulling away here in the first half. There you see Schellenberg just unable to control that ball. And Hamamoto makes no mistake. That's how it would be at halftime, 3-0 Japan. And there you see the Canadian supporters hoping for a better second half. And they get a chance here. Heather Lund plays for the University of Alberta Pandas. Just slips in the box and can't get a shot off. Showing just how slippery it was out on the pitch today. Next up, Takahashi will find Von Dahl off her line there. And she'll kiss that one in off the post. And in the 69th minute, Japan moves in front 4-0. And again, just a perfect shot there. Even though Von Dahl was off her line, not much she can do with a shot like that. Now late in this second half, Shoko Uemura, she'll get around Schellenberg and fire one home. 5-0 now Japan. You'll see just the good effort and the left-footed boot there, off the post and in. And that will do it. Japan will win its second ever bronze medal, defeating Canada 5-0 here in the bronze medal game. Some tears on the faces of the Canadians as they'd hoped for better, but still a good effort. Their best finish ever in women's Universiade football. And always great to see this at the end, a group picture taken with both teams. Japan, the bronze medalist in women's football. An extremely rainy day greeted the athletes here in Gwangju, making for very difficult conditions in all events. We'll take a look first at the women's high jump final. High winds and rain as mentioned. This is Madara Onuzane of Latvia. There her attempt at 1.80 meters. And she will make it on her first. We'll now look at Elizabeth Boyer of the United States. Her first attempt at 1.80 meters, and she easily gets over. That will be as high as both of those athletes would go, along with four others. We'll take a look, though, at Irene Palsite of Lithuania, a silver at Universiade in 2011. Here, her first attempt at 1.84, and she would clear it. And that's all she would need to win herself a gold medal. Palsite takes the gold. Boyer and Onuzane will each win silvers. Up next, the women's 1500 meters. Dokas Adjok of Uganda, she placed 11th in the 1500 at Kazan. And you see her there in the lead. In behind her, Gabriella Stafford of Canada. She was ninth at the 2014 World Junior Championships, and she will come in for silver. And then just at the last second, Stephanie Shappert falls behind Kristina Ugarova of Russia, and Ugarova will win the bronze medal. On next to the men's 800 meters, Reinert van Rensburg of South Africa. He's in lane four. He was sixth in this race in 2013 at Universiade in Kazan. And there you see him in first place, in second from Morocco. That's El Gesse. But Shaquille Walker will make a last minute burst from third place to the top of the podium. Gold medal for Shaquille Walker. Abdelhadi El Gesse of Morocco will win the silver. And Van Rensburg of South Africa takes bronze. Moving now to the men's 5,000 meters. Hale Ibrahimov of Azerbaijan, the defending Universiade gold medalist. He also won silver at last year's European Championships. And there you see him off on his own, well out in front. Second place right now held by Moroccan Zuhair Talbi. But no disputing the gold medalist here. Back-to-back Universiades for him. Hale Ibrahimov of Azerbaijan in a time of 13 minutes, 44.28 seconds. Talbi second. Akhmadeyev of Russia wins the bronze. You see the wet track greeting the participants in the women's 4x100-meter relay. They're around the first turn. Canada in lane 6 who actually dropped the baton, so they were out very early in this race. And you see there a bad exchange on the part of the Americans who were in first heading into that final handoff. But that is Victoria Ziapina. She has already won the women's 100 and 200-meter events here in Guangzhou, and she has just become a triple gold medalist. Kazakhstan wins gold. The Americans will take silver, and here you get a good look at that tough handoff they had. Could not make the exchange. And that opened the door for Ziapkina. And Kazakhstan, in a time of 44.28 seconds, finishes first. The Americans, 44.95 seconds, get the silver. And Thailand, 45.03 seconds, they will take home the bronze. Here on day 9, the rhythmic gymnastics all-around individual final from the Guangzhou Women's University. Since we do not have enough seats, we'll first look at Melitina Staniota of Belarus. Here she is with the ball. She won a silver in the hoop event at Kazan's Universiade in 2013 and also has 11 world championship medals to her credit. Go along with those, she's also won 10 European championship medals. She also competed for Belarus at the 2012 London Olympics. And there she finishes up her performance. Her coach likes it. She would score 17.800 on the ball and an overall score for her of 70.800. Now, Gana Rizatinova of Ukraine. She had a very strong Universiade at Kazan, winning 4 medals, the silver in clubs, 3 bronze in the all-around hoop and ball competitions. Also won gold in the hoop competition at the 2013 World Championships held at home in Ukraine in Kiev. And at the 2014 World Championships in Izmir, Turkey, she took home 4 bronze medals. There's the end of her performance. In the clubs, she would score 18.150. That would be second in that apparatus. Her overall score, 71.750. Now home favorite, Sun Yun-jae. You can see there her supporters cheering her on. She's the first Korean rhythmic gymnast to qualify and reach the all-around finals at the Olympics. Also won a bronze in the hoop last year at the World Championships in Izmir, Turkey. At Universiade in Kazan 2 years ago, she won a silver medal with the ball. And here in Guangzhou, she would finish atop the standings in the hoop, ball, and clubs here in the all-around. And her score on the ribbon would be 18.050. Do you get a close-up there of the footwork? And her overall score, 72.550. That will put her atop the standings in the individual all-around. Rizatinova, silver, and Staniota, the bronze. You're looking there at the Hwasun Hanyeom Sports Center in Guangzhou. The site for badminton competition here at Universiade will start with the mixed doubles final. This features from Korea Kim Gi-jung and Shin Sung-chan, and from Chinese Taipei, Chiang Kai-sin and Liu Ching-yao. Kim and Shin were already both medalists in mixed team badminton. And Kim was a double medalist back in Kazan in 2013, winning gold in the mixed doubles and bronze as well in the men's doubles. Korea in the near court. Chinese Taipei in red in the far court. A great rally here. Good effort there for Chinese Taipei. And that one will just fall out. And on game point, that will give Korea the opening game 21-14. Now the Koreans up big here in the second game, 8-1 right now. And a nice attack there by Shin. Korea up then 9-1. Moving on now to match point, 20-11, and that soft little backhand is enough to give the Koreans a gold medal. Chang and Liu will win silver. Go and Kim from Korea, as well as Tseng and Tie from Chinese Taipei, will win bronze. Next on the schedule, the women's singles gold medal match. This features Porntip Barana Prasertsuk of Thailand and Sung Ji-hoon of Korea. There's Sung serving here, trailing 11-7. She'd already won the opening game, 21-18. So Barana Prasertsuk needs to win this second game to stay alive. That one just lands in, bringing Sun back within three. Now 11-10, Barana Prasertsuk leading. And that smash just eludes the racket of Barana Prasertsuk. That ties it up at 11. Later in the game, 17-16, Sung now in front. She is the defending Universiade gold medalist, trying to repeat here at home in Gwangju, and that smash there to the back corner lands in. We're tied again at 17. 19-18 now, Sung in front. Another good rally here. And a cross-court smash there. Now 1 point away from gold for the Korean. And that one just lands out off the racket of Barana Prasertsuk. And for the second straight World University Games, Sung Ji-hyun wins the gold medal in women's singles badminton. Bronze medals go to Tai Tsu-ying of Chinese Taipei and Shiho Tanaka of Japan. The rains continued in Gwangju today, moving all tennis competition inside to the Yeomju Indoor Tennis Court. We'll start with the women's singles final. This features Luxika Kumkum of Thailand and Chiang Kai-shek of Chinese Taipei. Chiang won bronze in the mixed doubles here already. Actually previously played in the US Open in the opening round in that same year in 2009, defeated then number one world ranked Dinara Safina in a match in Japan. Right now, 5-1 in the second set. Chang won the opening set 6-1, and there's the winner for her to seal this gold medal. She'll win it 6-1, 6-2. Kum Kum will take silver. Wong Ten Chai of Thailand and Gumula of Indonesia each take the bronze. Now to the men's singles. Chung Hyun of Korea taking on Aslan Karatsev of Russia. As mentioned in the earlier highlights today, Chung is coming off an appearance at Wimbledon where he lost in the first round. He's currently ranked 78th in the world. up 3-love here in the third set. Chung there serving in the near court. Karatsev brings him to the net, and Chung will put that one away as he inches closer to a gold medal. Now 5-love here in the third set. And that winner will do it. Chung Hyun, gold medalist here in Guangzhou in men's tennis. He wins this match 1-6, 6-2, 6-love. Karatsev silver, Yang and Poulin will each win bronze. Over now to the mixed doubles final. Alexandra Walker and Darren Walsh of Great Britain taking on Lidzaya Mirozava and Andrei Vasilevsky of Belarus. There you see in the near court are the Belarusians. Walker and Walsh there in blue. And there's a winner for Walker. Belarus win the opening set 6-2. We're looking on here in the second set. And a nice winner down the line there for Mirozava. Another winner for her down the middle. And there on match point, Vasilevsky puts away the winner down the middle of the court. They will win this match 6-2, 6-3. Walker and Walsh will win the silver medals. Russia and Chinese Taipei win bronze.